Dear viewer, welcome to Samuel Academy. In this video, I want to bring to you a Bible story about Joseph. Joseph was the son of Jacob. His mother's name was Rachel. He had other brothers and a sister called Dinah. One of his brothers, the youngest of all, was called Benjamin. The mother of Joseph died in the land of Ephrath near Bethlehem. This is where Bethlehem is. This is the land of Egypt. This is the land of Canaan. And Bethlehem is here between the Dead Sea and the Mediterranean Sea. Let's continue. Bethlehem means house of bread. At 17 years, Joseph fed his father's flock together with his brothers. His father loved him more than all his brothers. He made him a coat of many colors. Look at the way a coat of many colors may look like. This is a coat of many colors, for example. Because Jacob loved Joseph more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak to him in a peaceful manner. They hated him again because of his dreams and his words. One day he had a dream. He dreamt that he was in the field with his brothers binding sheaves, that is, sheaves of grain. His sheaf arose and stood upright, and his brother's sheaves stood round about and did obeisance to his sheaf. Not only did his brothers hate him, but they also envied him. One day, they conspired against him to slay or kill him. His father sent him to see how they fared in the field with the cattle. When he came to them, they stripped him of his coat that had many colors and cast him in a pit. The pit was empty and without water. Judah told his brothers not to kill Joseph, but to sell him to the Ishmaelites. So they sold him to the Ishmaelites from Midian for 20 pieces of silver. Let's see where the land of Midian was. This is Egypt, this is the Red Sea, and this is the land of Midian. Alright? So they sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites from Midian for 20 pieces of silver, and Joseph was brought to Egypt. The brothers of Joseph beguiled their father that a wild beast had devoured him. In Egypt, Joseph was sold to Potiphar. Potiphar was an officer of Pharaoh and a captain of the guard. In Potiphar's house, the Lord was with Joseph, and Joseph was a prosperous man. Potiphar made Joseph overseer in his house. After some time, Potiphar's wife looked at Joseph and she admired him. She asked Joseph to lie with her, but he refused. He refused because she was Potiphar's wife and that he didn't want to sin against God because he had the fear of God. One day, Joseph was alone in the house with Potiphar's wife. Other men were outside. She caught him by his garment and asked him to lie with her. Joseph left his garment with her and fled. On seeing that, Potiphar's wife bore a false witness against Joseph. She told this false report to the men in the home, as well as to her husband, Potiphar, when he came back from work. He was very angry with Joseph, so he cast him in prison. In prison, the Lord was with Joseph, and he showed him mercy and gave him favor in the sight of the keeper of the prison, who put all the prisoners under Joseph. One day, two of Pharaoh's officers were cast in the same prison after offending Pharaoh. Later on, they both had dreams in the night. The dreams made them sad, and Joseph agreed to help interpret the dreams for them by the grace of God. He interpreted the dreams, one in favor of one of the officers, and to the other officer, the interpretation was not in his favor. Joseph told the officer to whom the interpretation was favorable to remember him before Pharaoh, but the officer, when he was restored in his position, he forgot all about Joseph. One night, Pharaoh had a dream. He didn't know what the dream meant, so he summoned all the magicians and wise men of Egypt to interpret the dream for him, but they could not. When the officer who had been previously in prison with Joseph heard about it, he introduced Joseph to Pharaoh as one that could interpret dreams. All right? As we continue, I request you to subscribe to this channel to be able to support this online learning, and that will be good. Let's continue. Now, Pharaoh commanded Joseph to be taken out of prison to interpret the dream for him. Joseph interpreted the dream for Pharaoh as 7 years of plenty in Egypt, followed by 7 years of famine that would be so severe. He also advised Pharaoh what to do because of the 7 years of famine. Pharaoh appointed Joseph to be ruler of Egypt, the second in command to Pharaoh. He took his ring and placed it on Joseph's hand. He also gave Joseph nice clothes and placed a gold chain about his neck. Joseph was 30 years old when he was made ruler in Egypt. He was given Asenath, that is Potiphar's daughter, as wife. Potiphar was the priest of On. Joseph was blessed with two sons, that is Manasseh and Ephraim. After 7 years of plenty were ended, there was 7 years of famine. The famine was so severe, even in the neighboring lands, including the land of Canaan. Because of the famine, Joseph's brothers came down to Egypt looking for food to buy. In Egypt, they met Joseph, but they did not recognize him, but he knew them. Joseph examined his brothers, gave them food, and returned their money in their bags, and sent them away back to Canaan, but he retained Simeon in Egypt. After a while, the brothers of Joseph had to return to Egypt to buy more food because the famine was so severe. They were required to go back to Egypt together with their youngest brother, Benjamin. It was not easy for Jacob to let Benjamin accompany his brothers to Egypt. Judah tried to persuade his father to let Benjamin accompanied them. And finally, he agreed. Jacob gave his sons presents, plus double the money for food to take to the king of Egypt. When the brothers of Joseph arrived in Egypt together with Benjamin, he received them and ordered a feast to be prepared for them. Even at this time, he did not reveal himself to his brothers. The feast was held in the house of Joseph. Joseph's brothers bowed themselves before him. When Joseph saw Benjamin, his brother, he sought a confirmation from the rest of his brothers if he was the youngest. Joseph was deeply moved and sought a place to weep. Let's continue. When he came back, he ate with his brothers, but gave to Benjamin a double portion of the food. After this, he sent them away together with their brother Simeon. But once again, he had a test for them. He put the silver cup from which he used to drink in Benjamin's sack. After the brothers left Egypt back to Canaan, he sent for them to come back, pretending that they had stolen his silver cup. They returned and were cross-examined again. Joseph could not control himself now. He revealed to them that he was Joseph, their brother, whom they sold in Egypt. He told them to go to Canaan and tell their father of the good news that he was still alive. He told them not to blame one another on the way, but to come back to Egypt with their father. The brothers of Joseph came back to Egypt with their father and were settled in the base of the land of Egypt, in the land of Goshen, at the command of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. So we find that this is the land of Egypt, and this is Goshen. This River Nile, and this is the Nile Delta. So Goshen was here. So they were settled in that, the base of the land of Egypt, land of Goshen. Alright? So we see that this story of Joseph is a picture of Jesus Christ, who came from heaven, he came to earth, died for our sins, arose from the dead, and went back to heaven. So because he died for us, we can be forgiven our sins. We can get eternal life because of Jesus Christ. If you find this video useful, subscribe, share widely, like, and leave a comment. Thank you so much.